A consummate banjo artist and educator, and perhaps the most influential banjo player in the roots music world, for more than 45 years, Tony TRISCHKA has inspired generations of bluegrass and acoustic musicians with the many voices he has brought to his instrument. A native of Syracuse, New York, TRISCHKA's interest in the banjo was first sparked in 1963 by the Kingston Trio, when the aspiring musician sent a letter to his idol, Pete Seeger, writing, "Dear Pete, you are the greatest banjo player in the universe." Seeger's response, "Music is not a horse race, there is no such thing as the best," became the guiding inspiration which would help shape Tony TRISCHKA's long and respected musical career. Beginning in 1965, TRISCHKA spent 15 formative years growing musically as he progressed through groups such as the Down City Ramblers, Country Cooking, Breakfast Special, and Country Granola. Drawing on the music of his youth, which included folk, jazz, and pop icons the Beatles, Tony TRISCHKA began the determined march away from traditional bluegrass, which would define his career. His first solo album, Bluegrass Light, set the tone for the plugged-in style of playing, which would allow TRISCHKA, in his own humble words, to break down some barriers for the banjo, blazing an experimental banjo pathway which won the respect of the old guard while simultaneously inspiring a new generation of banjoists through both his solo work and collaborations with his group Skyline. By the end of the 1980s, Tony TRISCHKA had come to be recognized as the sound of the modern five-string banjo. After spending two decades establishing his unique musical voice on numerous recordings, the theatrical stage, national public radio, and feature films, in 2007, Tony returned to his roots with his release of the CD, Double Bluegrass Banjo Spectacular. With fearless musical curiosity, fueled by musical interaction with the likes of Steve Martin, Earl Scruggs, and Bela Fleck, Double Bluegrass Banjo Spectacular not only tapped the creative potential of America's signature musical instrument, but went on to be nominated for a Grammy and win recognition as the IBMA Album of the Year. Not only amongst the most innovative of the banjo's players, Tony TRISCHKA is also one of its most respected and sought-after instructors as well. In addition to creating 15 instructional books, as well as a series of instructional DVDs, in 2009, he launched the groundbreaking Tony TRISCHKA School of Banjo, an advanced, interactive, online instruction site which has come to be recognized as the gold standard in banjo education, as well as a banjo home for aspiring students from around the world. The building of Tony TRISCHKA's diverse resume of career highlights continued with his co-producer and musical direction credits for the 2011 PBS documentary film Give Me the Banjo, producer credit for Steve Martin's Grammy-nominated CD Rare Bird Alert, and broadening the reach and influence of the banjo as a performer and bandleader in the 2012 New York City Shakespeare in the Park performances of As You Like It. Later that year, Tony TRISCHKA joined an elite group of America's most accomplished and innovative artists with his selection as a United States Artist Friends Fellow. His 2008 CD, Territory, firmly established Tony TRISCHKA the composer, utilizing 12 original compositions to roam widely through the banjo's creative terrain in this critically acclaimed release. Employing a plethora of tunings, sounds, traditions, and stellar collaborations, Territory set the stage for Tony's most recent and compelling artistic showcase, Great Big World. With sterling contributions from artists such as Steve Martin, Noam Pikelny, Ramblin' Jack Elliott, and many others, Great Big World finds Tony TRISCHKA embracing delightful new possibilities for the banjo while maintaining vigilant respect for the bluegrass roots which were his musical inspiration. Respected as a trailblazer to the current generation of roots music artists, Tony Trischka, through a lifetime of musical innovation, continues to fulfill a calling through his consistent and enlightened elevation of the standards of music and perception associated with the once humble banjo.